We meet Kwame Williams at what he calls a personal crossroads, the intersection of Lansdowne Street and Mass Ave in Cambridge.
Two blocks away is the Aerospace Engineering Lab, and then literally just right over here is D-Lab.
Two labs at MIT that Williams knows well. He came to the U.S. with his family from Ghana in the fourth grade and fell in love with aviation and robotics.
By the end of high school, I said, where's the best university for aerospace engineering? And I learned that that was MIT, and from that point on, I was just singularly focused on getting to MIT.
He did. He interned for NASA, but then returned to Ghana for a visit, and everything changed.
I got to see rural poverty for the first time. And I started to ask myself, if aerospace engineers can help put a man on the moon, then what can I do to help put more food on the table for these families?
The answer he found already growing in his native home, the moringa tree.
True moringa got its birth from an MIT class project.
True Moringa is the Cambridge-based beauty and wellness company Williams founded with Emily Cunningham.
We were in Ghana on a school project. We met farmers who were working with the moringa tree, and Peace Corps and other NGOs had basically told them to plant moringa because the leaves are so nutritious, but they couldn't afford to continue growing moringa because they weren't making money from it. And so that's kind of where we came in with our project to take the unused part of the tree, which are the seeds, and turn it into oil.
Oil that can be used in a vast array of skincare products.
Moringa oil has kind of been on the fringe of the cosmetic industry for a while. Its story is kind of similar to that of argan or jojoba.
All the pressing and processing for True Moringa happens in Ghana.
We're impacting about 25,000 people through our supply chain. Secondly, we've been able to plant over 2 million trees all across the country, and our trees are actually becoming a solution to malnutrition.
In a time where a lot of the commodities that we're getting are really extractive, moringa provides a solution that you're getting a really wonderful oil, but you're also giving back to people and planet.
The World Wildlife Fund says the production of palm oil, used in more than half of packaged products consumed in the U.S., including cosmetics, is to blame for the razing of tropical forests in Asia, Africa, and Latin America.
These are tiny little farms. They're like the size of your backyard.
SourceMap monitors supply chains for companies. It was founded by Leonardo Bonanni while he was a student at the MIT Media Lab.
SourceMap was based on a simple idea that people have a right to know where things come from.
Customers are alerted if they find problems.
Is there a school in that village that's available for the children to go to? Is there a working water pump or health clinic? Is there deforestation? We've been using satellite imagery to look at palm oil plantations and say, hey, is that palm oil plantation growing into a part of the world where deforestation is happening?
Clean beauty company Beauty Counter has been working with SourceMap to monitor its supply chain, including mica mines. Lindsay Dahl is Beauty Counter's Senior Vice President of Social Mission.
The mica industry is notorious for having issues within the supply chain around labor issues, so forced labor, wage theft, and sometimes child labor.
Mica is used in everything from paints to electronics to makeup, the shimmer in lipstick, the sparkle in eyeshadow. Harvard Business School professor Nian Hashia says one issue is lack of regulation. In addition,
mining in general, you add on top of that, is just a very messy kind of operation.
Often large-scale mines are surrounded by smaller so-called artisanal mines.
A lot of these questions we're talking about with regard to child labor and things like that are things that aren't legally supposed to be happening, but they do happen because of the way these mining operations are structured.
Beauty Counter recently completed a physical audit of all their mica suppliers.
In some cases, we've dropped mica suppliers within our supply chain. Solving sourcing issues is arguably one of the hardest things that we are faced with, but it's absolutely worth it. We're not going to solve this issue alone, but sometimes it takes a first company to kind of raise the alarm to say, look, we need to do better, and we're at least going to try. That is how we've seen transformative change in other industries, and we feel like we can help do the same kind of large-scale change within the beauty industry.
And Beauty Counter says that supply chain transparency really helped to transform the coffee and the chocolate industry. They think it can do the same for the beauty industry.
Yeah, and as in terms of clean products, look for brands that disclose the ingredients. And if you're interested in learning more about your particular brand's environmental working group, it actually has a free database where you can check everything out, and they rank the safety of the products. So it's a good thing, because you never know what you're putting on your face.
There's a lot of data out there, which is nice. Up next, recycling your look.